Well, here we are, folks. It's 2020, and for some reason or another, you decided to update your 2010 MacBook. It's heavy. And let's get into it.
This is a step-by-step process video. What you will need. For this upgrade, I wanted extra storage and improved memory. These items are listed in the description of this video. For the mid-2009 to mid-2012 MacBook models, the most RAM they can support at this time is 16 gigabytes. I purchased a 16 gigabyte kit consisting of two 8 gigabyte memory card slots. I needed to purchase a screwdriver set specifically for MacBook Pro, as the screws are not standard screws. The SATA USB cable is used to transfer data from the old hard drive to the new solid state drive. I recommend the 1TB Samsung EVO 860. I wanted lots of space and the best performing hard drive for this MacBook. In total, these items cost about $240 with tax. Step 1. Plug in the charger and turn on your MacBook. You want to be sure that your Mac has enough power during this process, since we will be transferring data. Now consider how it will be best for you to move the documents from the old hard drive. There are two options. The first is to copy your important documents from your old computer manually into a thumb drive or SD card or an external hard drive. Then use these tools to transfer the files to your new SSD, which you will be putting into the computer. The second option is to copy directly the entire hard drive in the old computer using disk utility. Both options will be shown in this video. Step 2. Insert the SATA cable into the SSD and plug into your old Mac. This SSD right now works the same way as an external hard drive. It will be internal soon, but for now it is external, or outside of your laptop. Plug the USB into your old Mac. Step 3. Go to the Spotlight search and search for Disk Utility. Step 4. Right now, this new Samsung SSD can work in either a Windows or a Mac computer. We need to format the Samsung SSD to make it work for a Mac computer. The format will be Mac OS Extended Journal Encrypted. Click Erase. Step 5. Shut down the computer to restart in recovery mode. Step 6. To initiate recovery mode, hold Option Command R power button for about 20 seconds. This computer had been disconnected from Wi-Fi for about 5 years. Initiating recovery mode prompted me to connect to a Wi-Fi network. Step 7 has two options depending on how you would like to transfer data. The first option is to copy the entire old hard drive onto the new SSD. Once you get to the recovery mode menu, select Disk Utility. Here we can see the old internal drive, Mac HD, and the new drive listed under External. Mount each drive again by clicking on Restore. Here I accidentally renamed the new SSD as OS X Base System. Please note to select the new external drive in this process, nothing from the disk images area. After this is done cloning, it will give you a green check mark. Shut down the computer and restart it to check to see if the documents have been transferred over. Option 2 is to simply format the new Samsung SSD to work with Mac. If you do not care to copy your documents using the disk utility, you can transfer what you need to a USB and then just format the new Samsung SSD so that it can work with Mac. This option means that there will be no old files on the new computer. Disconnect the SATA cable from the MacBook and new Samsung SSD. Shut down the Mac, and now you are ready to install the new hard drive into your computer. In this bag, there are several screwdriver sizes and a pry tool used to disconnect the battery. There are three screws which are longer than the other screws. Keep them in a safe place and remember which screws belong to which holes. Be mindful of the surface you are working on. Make sure it is an anti-static surface. Detach the battery connector with one of the tools. The hard drive is at the bottom left corner. unscrew the hard drive. Keep the screws in a safe place. Lift the hard drive using the plastic pull tab. Later on, this tab will be placed on your new Samsung hard drive. Carefully remove the SATA connector from the old hard drive. It can be easy to break this connector, so be very gentle. On the hard drive, there are four screws. Unscrew these screws and keep them in a safe place. Replace the screws from the old hard drive and screw them into the new Samsung SSD. Remove the plastic tab from the old hard drive and stick it on the new hard drive for later use. The new hard drive is now ready to be connected to the MacBook. Carefully connect the SATA cable and place the hard drive inside. Align the screws and replace the parts. Now it is time to upgrade the RAM memory inside the MacBook Pro. A MacBook Pro can hold up to 16 gigabytes of RAM. To remove the memory, push out the two plastic retaining bars until the modules pop up. There are two memory cards in this MacBook, each 4 gigabytes, totaling 8 gigabytes. Be very gentle and try to use the retaining bars to remove the RAM. Here we can see a shorter notch on the left side and a longer end on the right side. Line up the new memory cards with the notches. Slide the modules into the lower slot at an angle until fully seated. Slide in the module until it clicks into place. Be very careful with this process. Reconnect the battery. Now we are ready to turn it on. Before replacing all of the screws, turn on the power button to make sure that the RAM is inserted correctly. If the Mac makes three beeps, it means that the RAM is not properly inserted. Shut down the computer, disconnect the battery, and remove and replace the RAM carefully just to be sure it is installed correctly. Turn on the Mac again in recovery mode. You can achieve this by pressing Command R and Power at the same time. Now that the new SSD is inside of the computer, initiate reinstall Mac OS from the recovery menu. The installation of Mac OS High Sierra is initiated from the menu.
Okay, so after you follow the prompt, it should take you to this page and automatically download Mac OS High Sierra. If the hard drive did not appear on this page, you can press Command Q and then go back to Disk Utility and erase, select this drive and erase it and format it into Mac OS Extended Journal format. Then go back to hit Command Q and go back to the same, through the same process, and it should appear. So just going to the Disk Utility and formatting it in Mac OS Extended Journal should fix the issue and make it appear. Mine will take about an hour and 46 minutes.
I am quite happy with the results. The computer runs very smoothly, and the only downside is the camera is older, but it's not that bad. And it's very strange because this is not like a 10-year-old computer. We created a station to connect the screen to the TV during this time that we have multiple Zoom meetings throughout the day. Look at all these ports! Ethernet, HDMI, and even an SD card slot to help with organizing photos and videos. I am very grateful for this upgraded computer. The computer loads websites pretty quickly and the display looks great. With these upgrades, the computer became useful and it is nice to have on hand. It works well as a secondary computer. Thank you for watching and please subscribe for more.